So good morning everybody, welcome to this lovely Monday morning. Today we are going to work on activating, stabilising, strengthening our glutes, our backs, a little bit of shoulders and core, a bit of flow in between, and then some hip opening stretches as well. So we're just going to start mostly in our wide knee here. Okay, so we're bringing our knee out as wide as the mat into the middle part of the mat. Big toes come to touch, or your sit bones gently resting back onto your heels. And we're just going to rest one forearm on top of the other. Okay. And have the arms enough in front of you so that the forehead can gently just rest onto the forearms. Okay? So from here, with the eyes closed, softening into the armpits, into the shoulders, into the hips, knees, ankles, and toes, just take your awareness to your breath. So the breath is fundamental to your stretch reflex. A nice big inhale, drawing in the oxygen, and the exhale, just finding the release, finding your letting go point. Okay, remember, whenever you come into a stretch, particularly the one that's maybe a little bit challenging, your body will automatically go into its fight-flight mechanism. So you want to push past that with your breath, just really eliciting your relaxation response so that you can gently evolve in whatever it is you're asking your body to do. So just bring our awareness to our breath and we're gently inhaling through our nose, exhaling, just finding that softness evolving. Just allow yourself to be surrounded in stillness. As we inhale, just gently float the forehead off the forearms, extend the arms out in front of you, shoulder width apart, keeping the sit bones resting back onto heels, just gently elongate, lengthen the arms, side body, front body, forehead may rest on the mat, it might just gently sit in between the arms. Would you actively press the four corners of the hands, finger pads into the mat, and draw length to the arms, slightly pulling back into the shoulders to stretch it underneath your lats. So kind of pull the shoulder blade apart a little bit. Lovely, and we'll just slide the hands to come into our classic tabletop. So once we come up, we're sat on all four limbs, ensuring that the heels of the hands are below the shoulders, knees are under hips, feet are hips width, and our feet are out in a straight line behind our knees. So feel like you're pressing the floor away with your hands rather than sinking down into your mat. We'll just do a couple of rounds of cat-cow, inhaling to dip the spine. Lengthen forward, broaden, lengthen, widen the ribcage, right up into the crown head, right into the tail. And on your exhale, rolling curling. So nice concave, chin to chest, nose to navel. And then inhale, finding your dip. So again, we all have different breath lengths, so just work with your own breath pattern and find the movement evolving from the beginning of the breath to the end of the breath. There's almost an added natural pause point in between each cycle of breath. Maybe keeping the eyes closed. And just feeling how each movement evolves, the stretches, maybe engagement, maybe contraction through the spine, through the shoulders, through the arms, through the legs. Lovely. Last time to curl in, nice deep chin to chest. And then we'll come to sit up, butt cheeks down onto our heels. Classic hair pose, we lengthen the arms away. Stretch out those fingers, lengthen out those arms. And then from here as we inhale, we'll push up onto the knees, slide the hands towards the knees, tuck that tail and stretch it back. Exhaling into our hair pose. Inhaling into our extended table. So hips to forward from the knees, shoulders sat down over the hands, and as we exhale, bend it from elbows, nose tips. Press it all the way up, back into your hip pose. Inhale, float back up onto your knees, tuck the tail, reach it back. We're only doing one tricep press up at a time so that we can really pay for awareness. Shoulders come forward and stack it up. As you bend from the elbows, keep bellies off the floor, nose tips. Inhale, press it up, exhale back into head. Float it all the way back to the knees, tuck the tail, reach, stretch it back. Exhale, head pose again. Inhale, extend to tabletop, exhale, bend from elbows, tip the nose, press it up, take it back to head pose. Last time, inhale, float it all the way up and back. Good. Exhaling into head pose. Good. Inhaling into our tabletop. Okay. So from our tabletop, tucking that lovely belly button into spine. So already feel your core drawn in, pelvic floor lifted. And we'll just do a little side cat. So we're going to bring right hip to right shoulder, a little squeeze. Really feel the squeeze in that side waist. And then as we come back to center, we'll take left hip to shift, left shoulder, shoulder to hip. So it's a squeeze in the middle. And back to center, out to the right. Squeeze. Back to center. Out to the left. And squeeze. Lovely. Then we'll come back to our center point, take ourselves back into our hair pose. Inhaling, floating hands towards knees, come up high, tuck and tail under, reach your back. Exhale, head pose. Inhale, extended tabletop, exhale, this time coming all the way down, chest wall drops, legs and feet slide away, inhale, pose. Exhale, to come down, slide the hands back a little bit, press up through table, curl toes under, downward facing dog. Exhale. And again, inhale into head, exhaling. All the way down, floating hands to knees, tuck tail under, reach it back. Exhale, the head. Inhale, extended. Exhale, chest wall drops, legs and feet slide away. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, to float it down. Inhale, press up through tabletop. Exhale, curl toes under, downward facing dog. Inhale to hair pose. Exhale, lovely. One more time. Tuck that tail under. Reach it back. Exhale, hair pose. Inhale, extended. Exhale, chest wall drops. Legs, feet slide. Inhale, cobra. Exhale, down tabletop as we inhale. Exhale, curl toes under downward facing dog. Just stay here for a few breaths. Lengthening the arms, feeling that you're not just pressing the tips of the fingers and the heels and the hands in the mat, but right at the base of those fingers. Drawing down towards the heels as you lift your butt cheeks up. Lovely, and then we'll inhale and on to our tabletop. So classic tabletop here. And we'll curl the toes under. So from here, really engage your core, pelvic floor. Don't let your shoulders sink down to the mat. So you want to lift into the shoulders. And then with the toes curled under, we're going to float the knees off the mat about an inch or 2 inches. Good. We're going to keep our left leg very stable with the knee floated off the mat. Reach our right leg back and top it up. And reach it back. And tuck it up. So keep thinking, pelvic floor, belly button to spine, press with the four corners of the hands, lift to the shoulders, last time to press it back, drop your left knee, soften the left foot onto the mat, inhale, float your right arm, left arm out in front of you. Press back to that right heel, pressing lengthen forward to your left fingertips. And then we're going to take it off centre, so right leg scoops out a little bit, left arm scoops out a little bit. Okay. And we're going to go across the tummy, so elbow to knee, and back out wide again. Elbow to knee, And back out wide. Elbow to knee. Back out wide again. Last time, elbow to knee. Back out wide again. And then from here, we're going to swing our right leg over to the left side of the mat, our left arm over to the right side of the mat. So we're going to look side bend. And then as we bring ourselves back into our center point, I'm going to thread the needle of the right arm behind the left, all the way across, resting fully on the side edge of that right arm. Keep the feet hips width. Press fully down into that right arm, right shoulder. And then we'll throw the left arm up to the side, reaching up to the fingertips. So draw that chest up and off your right arm, stick the arm around, catch hold, baby, off your right thigh. Lift that left shoulder and mat a little bit. Press fully down into the right arm. And then inhale, coming back into your center point. Exhale, just bring yourself into your hip pose. Lovely, and coming back into that tabletop. So remember that lovely stack? Rather than letting the chest fall sink, we're pressing up into the shoulders, we're engaging the four corners of the hand. We're drawing belly button to spine, encouraging that lovely pelvic floor lift, curl toes under. And then again, floating the knees about an inch or two off the mat. And really then, press away with the hands, left leg back, and then bring it in. Left leg back, and bring it in. Left leg back, and bring it in. Keep your right knee stable off that mat. One more time. As we bring it back in, okay, we're going to drop down to our knees, okay? Relax the feet onto the mat. Sorry, I should have told us to keep the leg back and float our right arm in front of us. Good, and then we're going to take it off centre a little bit. So right arm swinging out to right, left leg out to the left. And then it's elbow to knee under the body. And out to the side again. Elbow to knee under the body. Out to the side. Elbow to knee. Out to the side. Last time, elbow to knee. As we take it out to the side now, here we're going to swing our left leg over to the right side of the mat. Our right arm over to the left side of the mat. As if you're pushing away to both sides. And then as we come back into our centre point, I'm going to thread the needle of the left arm behind the right. Square off those lovely feet. Lift up into your right side. Right arm goes up, sweeps behind the back. Catch a hold maybe of your left hip, left side waist. Lift your right chest up and off that left arm. Lovely. And then we'll bring ourselves back into our center point and then back into our hair pose. From hair pose, just slide your hands back. So we're just sitting onto our heels. Inhale, open the arms out wide, higher than the shoulders. Puff out that side rib cage, front rib cage, and press back with the arms, really stretching out the shoulders. And then make a little fist with the two hands, sweep the hands behind the back, and interlace the knuckle joints into one another. Lift the shoulders and roll them back, and just press the elbows back. Lovely. Just get a nice stretch to the shoulders here. And then releasing the arms out wide again. Exhale, taking it into hair pose. Into our extended tabletop, exhale, curl toes under sit bones, back towards our heels, flowing knees off the mat, down, facing dog. Good, so just spend a few breaths here. You're just experiencing where perhaps you feel personally your level of where you might just feel that little bit of tightness. Is it your hamstrings? Is it the ankles? Is it the shoulders? And just breathe gently, deeply and evenly into those spaces. One more breath here. And then we'll pop onto the knees. We'll cross the legs over. Roll over, bums come to lie down. Okay. So make sure the bum comes into the middle, help the mask as you lie down. Okay. Just take a wee moment here to press the lower back into the mat and draw the belly button into the spine. So when we relax fully on the mat like this, the knees bent, okay, it's a natural thing to have a lower back curve at your hip. So we want to activate the core, curl the tail up a little bit, and just draw the belly button into the spine, okay? So you feel the whole of the mat back onto the mat. So just stay here for a wee moment, just feeling that lovely draw in. Lovely. So from here, we're going to activate our glutes. So we're going to take our elbows, okay, and rest them onto the mat, either side of the body. Okay. Walk the feet in, make sure they're 2-3 inches away from the body to make the feet hips width. So just reach down, maybe you can feel your heels, maybe you can't. Okay. So from here, rest the arms down directly either side of the body. And from here, with all four corners of the feet into the back, we're going to roll, curl, lift the hips, and press up into our bridge pose. So when we come into bridge pose, we want to lift our hips, hug into our pelvis. Okay, and just use the hands on the floor. So we're going to do a little stretch from here, just lengthen out. So we're going to take our right arm, reach across our body, above our left shoulder, reach away, keep the hips up high, and then bring that arm back down, and do the same with the left arm, up and over the body, reach above our right shoulder, and then all the way back down, same with right, over that left shoulder, try not to let the hips drop down, left arm over right shoulder, and back we come. One more time each side. Reach above and over. Bring that arm back down. Left arm up and over that shoulder. Bring it all the way back down. Gently release the spine to the mat. So you should have felt your core reactivating here, as well as getting a nice back stretch. Tuck the knees into the chest. Give ourselves a nice deep squeeze. And come into our happy baby. So slide the hands to the side edge of the feet. In steps, if mat's not available, to your shins. Press the feet up to the ceiling, take the knees out wide. Really hook onto those feet, smooth down into your tail. Inhale, draw those legs down. Thighs smoothing past your ribcage. I want you to really use those arms effectively to draw those thighs down. One more breath here. And then we'll pop those 2 feet back down onto the mat. So you're finding your bridge pose position again, 2-3 inches away from your buttocks. Feet hips width, okay? Feel all four corners of the feet pressing against the mat. And I'm just going to bend the arms from the elbows, point the fingertips up to the sky, so that the triceps are pressed onto the floor. So we push into the floor, the backs of our arms, the fingertips are pointed up to the sky. Okay. And again, we're going to inhale, float up into our bridge pose. So again, hug into the pelvis, lift those hips, puff out that lovely chest wall. So we're going to ground into our left foot here, and lift our right knee off, right foot off the floor, okay, with the knee still bent. Bring the knee above its hip, okay, and then we're just going to press it out to the side and in and lower it down. And lift it up, out to the side, in and down. So whilst we're doing this here, what you'll notice is there's a little bit of fatigue, a little bit of tightness coming into our left glute and our left hip. Keep the lift, out to the side, in and down. Last one, right out to the side, in and down. Put your bums back down onto the floor. Okay, cross your right ankle bone over your left thigh, left foot off the mat. So square that left knee above its left hip. We want to draw our right shin in towards our chest wall, or put our right knee away. And I want you to see, can you get your forearm of your left arm just around the outside edge, so your little toe side of your left foot. Okay. If that's unavailable to your hand, it's fine. We're hugging it into us. Good, and we're really trying to get that shin nice and close in towards our chest wall. Good, and then we'll extend the left leg away, nice straight leg, press away to the heel, and just let it lower to the ground, and release. Keep that right shin really snuggled across this chest wall. Lovely, and then we'll release that right foot back into our bridge pose position. So always check in, tailbone tucked, belly button drawn to spine. Triceps on the mat, fingers facing towards the ceiling. And then we'll inhale, curl up, tail on, press up into our bridge pose again, hug it into our pelvis, and popping up that little lovely chest wall. This time left knee's coming, left foot's coming off the mat. Okay. And then we're dropping the knee out to the side, bringing it back to center, and lowering it down. So keep pressing all four corners of your right foot onto the mat. Keep that hip lift. Okay. Feel your core really working. Feel your glute activating in that right leg. Out to the side again. Into center. Down. Last one. Out to the side. Into center. Down we go. Release it all the way down. This time, left ankle bone over right thigh, left right foot off the mat. Square right knee above its hip. And we're gently drawing in. So you can just hold onto the side edge of our left foot with our right hand and gently press forward with our left hand into the inside of that left knee. You want to get your forearm wrapped around that outside edge of the foot to give it a little bit more draw in. Remember, we want to press the knee away as we draw the foot shin in. And then we'll straighten our right leg away from us, lower it down as far as it can go to the floor, but I want you to keep that right leg active, so no bent knees or sagging the leg. We're just pressing away to that heel, lowering the leg as low as it can go. Lovely. One more breath, really stretching out that lovely hip. And then we'll bend the right knee, put the left foot back down onto the mat, find and reset it into that bridge pose position. Triceps are on the mat, fingertips are facing up to the ceiling. And again, inhale, curl tail and rip the spine off the mat. Pressing up into our bridge pose, roll that front chest wall into the chin. So again, if you're finding the last one we just did a little bit challenging, maybe stay with that and do it again rather than taking it forward. See how you get on with this one here now. So we're going to inhale, right leg's going up to sky. Flexion to that right foot and push up to the ceiling. Okay, and then from here we're going to swing the leg out to the side, straight. Bring it up, lower the bum almost to the floor, press it up again. Out to the side, all the way to center, lower almost down, press it up, out to the side as wide as you can go, up we go, almost to the floor, press it up, last time, out to the side, back to center, almost to the floor, press it up. And then release the right foot down, smooth the back arm to the mat, tuck the knees into the chest. Pop your left foot down onto the mat, okay? coming into half happy baby with our right leg. Okay, so we're swinging the knee way out of line of the side body. And then I want you to roll onto the little toe side of your left leg. Okay, place your hand gently to the inside of the thigh and just press down as you draw that right knee down to the mat. Okay. So for some, this might just be enough. If you want a little bit more, you're going to curl up, okay, and take your right arm, right shoulder inside that of your right leg. Take your right hand underneath your butt cheek, okay, and then just hold onto your toes. Rest your head back down onto the mat. And just breathe it out. So we're not straightening that right leg, we're just trying to open our hip. So use that left knee, draw it down wide. And then we'll release that all down, resetting for our bridge pose, last one on this side. So 2 to 3 inches away from the mother's feet, hips width. Triceps pressed into the mat, fingertips up to the sky, lower back's embedded in the mat first. And then inhale, curl, tail, press, and up into your bridge pose. Lifting that lovely front chest wall into the chin, left leg's coming up. So press up to the heel, lift the hips a little bit higher. So left leg's swinging up to the side. It's coming all the way up. Bum's coming almost to the mat. And then you press it up. Out to the side. Up to center. Bump almost to the mat, lift and press, out to the side, into center, almost to the mat, press it up, out to the side, well done, into center, almost to the mat, press it up, last time, up to center, almost to the mat, press it up. And then release that left foot to the floor, roll it all the way down, tuck the knees into the chest. Good, as we pop the feet down to the mat, we're coming half happy baby with our left leg, and letting our right knee roll out. So you can gently press your right hand onto your right inside thigh, draw that left knee down. Good. Again, if you want to get a little bit more, we're going to draw the knee down a little bit close to mat, curl up the head and neck, just scoop our left arm, left shoulder in behind our left thigh, tuck our left hand in underneath our right, our left butt cheek, and just hold onto your toes and your side edges of your feet, and just let the weight drop you down into the mat here. So you could just be holding your half happy baby, okay? Or you can tuck in that shoulder in. And then we'll release it all the way up. Tuck the knees into the chest. Cross the legs over. We're going to roll over our feet. Step back into our plank pose. Suck the thighs in. Draw the belly button to spine. Stack the shoulders directly over the heels and hands. Feel like you're pushing away the floor. With the hands pressing back to the heels. Lovely. And then we'll pop the knees to the mat, hugging that belly. Exhale, bend from the elbows, drop that chest wall, slide the legs and feet away. Lift and lengthen each leg away from you and come then up onto your elbows for your Sphinx pose arms. So we're making sure, okay, that the elbows are sitting directly in underneath the shoulders. We've lengthened the legs the way the toes are engaged in the mat. And from here, press the forearms, hands into the mat, and lengthen from the elbows right up into the shoulders. So you get that active Sphinx pose. And then from here, we're going to concave the belly. So we're drawing belly button to spine and really finding that core engaged. Okay, so remember the difference from the Sphinx pose here is with the thighs fully pressed on the mat, and as we inhale, we're lifting up into the shoulders, a little back bend. And when we come into this core engagement, it's concave in the belly,
So you're rounding and the spine and drawing the chin into your chest. Lovely. And then from here, from this round thing, I want you to hug everything into the middle and just float the hips off the mat about 2 or 3 inches. And just feel the whole of that core really drawn in, the shoulders engaged, everything's working. And just breathe into this. Lovely. And then relax the thighs, keep the bum down to the mat, and just reach up into your sphinx pose again. And we're going to do that one more time. So it's concave in the belly, rounding the chin into the chest. And then from here, just floating the pelvis off the mat. Keep the drawing the belly button to spine, the lift into the shoulders, the chin into the chest. You should feel the whole of the abdomen ribcage really hugging in here. And then we'll release that down. Side hands in underneath the shoulders. Press up through your table, curl toes under downward facing dog. And again, just settling here for a few breaths. Just getting the correct hand to leg position that works for you so that we can release nicely out towards our heels. Feel the inside legs nice and active as if you're pressing the insteps against a solid surface. Lovely. And then we're just going to pop onto our knees. So we're going to use our blocks here. So we're going to take a block in each hand, okay, and just extend the left leg forward. So we're coming into our half split position, where our right hip's above our right knee, our left heel is in front of us, okay, and we can find that we can rest the hands comfortably onto the block. Okay, so firstly, just activating that hamstring, pressing the heel in, drawing the slip bone back, drawing the toes towards the nose. Okay, and then you're going to use your block just as like an isometric stretch here. We're going to lift that leg up and just hold. Keep drawing the toes towards the nose, and pushing the heel away. And then once we lower it down, we're just going to take the sole of the foot, place it onto the mat. You can take your block so that you walk the foot. Press that left knee forwards and really send your right hip forward towards the floor. Lovely. And then from here, bring the pelvis back. So you want to make sure that the left knee sits over the left ankle. I'm going to curl the toe under the right foot, lift the right knee, and just keep shimming that right leg back without displacing your front knee. And then place the top of the foot onto the mat again. Lovely. So now we've got left knee above left ankle, you can see, okay? And we've got as much length back with this right leg as we can. You can use your blocks on your tall side to press it up if you need to. But what we're gonna do here now is to bend our right knee, okay? Once you've bent the right knee, maybe you're still keeping one hand on the block, reaching back with your right hand. Drawing that heel into your elbow, maybe you're reaching back with the left hand as well. And as we draw the heel into the bottom, okay, you can use your blocks to balance you. So there's only one hand to balance you out. Just breathe. Now push yourself back into that foot as well, but keep the left knee directly over that left ankle. Super duper quad stretch here. Lovely. And then just gently releasing it out. Once you've released it out, take the right knee out wide, okay? And bring the right foot behind the right knee, toe curled under, okay? Lovely. Slide your left foot back a little bit, press your left knee forward, right hip forward, left hand onto left leg, reach up towards the front of the room. Elbow can come onto the hand, onto the knee, or you can place your hand on the block. But right hip's moving forward, really exposing your hip flexor here. To press it forward. Lovely. And then we'll take our hand back down onto the block, curl that toe under, lift the knee back into its space, curl toe under the back foot, lift that back knee, swivel your right heel down, coming into pyramid pose, just gently walk the blocks away from you. Lovely, so placing the blocks at the front of the mat, okay, we're going to inhale, float all the way up, so we're going to come into triangle, just give a little stretch back. As we float it all the way around and forward to that left leg, right arm's reaching down to left little toe, left arm's reaching out behind us. Inhale as we come back. We're going to bend our left knee, reverse down that leg. Inhaling as we come up, press our right butt, cheek butt, exhale into classic triangle pose. Lovely, and then from here we're just going to bend that left knee, hug that left knee to the left elbow, turn it around a little bit, looking up at that lovely right thumb. And then as we swivel the two hands back down either side of that front foot, we're going to come onto the ball of our right foot, sweep our left leg up to the sky, three-legged dog. Bend our left knee, pushing our left foot to the right side of the mat. We'll drop it out into a modified side plank. Toe tips, hips over the arm, reaches to the sky. Try not to slide that right foot away. You want to keep that lovely height of the hips. And then as you come down, we're going to put left hand back down. Roll onto the sole of our right foot. Scoop our left leg through. Catch hold of our left big toe with our right hand. Push it away. Yeah. And then from here, as we come back, so hand shoulder width, back onto the ball of our right foot, float that right leg up to the sky, three-legged dog. And now we're gonna take left foot to left little finger side. So once you're there, hands are shoulder width apart, pelvis squares off, right leg slides away. And just lift your heart center. So we're in a wide leg position here now. So we're drawing our right hip forward to our right elbow. We're keeping our left knee hugged into our left tricep. Okay. Then as you drop your right knee, it stays in line with your right hand. Okay. I want you to bring your blocks and place them in between, as if that's where your elbows would be. So we're up on our hands here. Send the hips forward, lift up. And then from here, we're going to take an elbow onto each block and just interlace the fingers. Squeeze the left knee into the left shoulder, take the eye gaze forward. And from here, just lift and engage your back leg. So you just float the knee off the mat, push back to that heel. So we're not full as a pose here. I want you to just really experience the hugging in, okay? Rather than letting the knee of the right leg spill in or the knee of the left leg spill out, we want everything really engaged. Push it back to that heel. Love it. So when we replace that right knee, we want it back where it was. Pressing up onto straight arms, okay? Walk that leg away if you need to. We're keeping this left knee hugged in, okay? And we're doing exactly the same. We're gonna bend the right knee. Reach back with the right hand, draw the heel in. Reach back with the left hand, draw the heel in. So you have an opened hip. And sit up nice and tall into it. Lovely, and then as we release it out, okay? Just rolling onto the little toe side of that left foot. So you can see that left knee is going out. Super, and then we're going to use one of the blocks. So the left block's coming in a diagonal place across your mat. We're going to scoop that left leg over, bring the side edge of our left thigh into our lovely open hip position for our pigeon pose. Square off your pelvis. And you can take the block out in front of you, okay? And we can rest the forearms onto that block. If it's too much to lay over the leg, just stay with your block and stay upright, okay? But we're just resting into this. Occasionally increasing the length away on that right leg.
So just find that release point, that point where your kind of brain is going, can I get out of this please, to just you breathing in and through it. Lovely. So as you come off this, just bring your blocks around with you. Just come into
an easy cross leg, but without the legs crossed over the shin. So we're going to kick our right heel into our pelvis and our left shin in front of us. And the same thing here, you can use your block here to come into a forward fold. If you don't need your blocks, just put them out to the side behind you, ready for the other side. So from here, your left butt cheek will feel like it's floating off the mat. So you don't need to fold down as much. Perhaps you can just rest onto your elbows, onto this block. Okay, so just finding a place where we're keeping the butt cheeks engaged the mat and you're really feeling that in your left hip. So you don't have to fold down at all. You can just find where you find your best release point. Lovely. And then from here, just swing the left foot back. Okay, little zigzag shape. And fold down the mat towards the back edge of the mat. Reaching with that left arm just a little bit more. Great, so as we slide the hands back in, just press it back into your downward facing dog. Again, three nice long breaths here, lifting the front parts of the leg, reaching out to the heels, drawing the belly button to spine. Really finding this lovely space in your hip flexor as well. And then we'll come on to our knees again. We'll take the block to the side of us and extend our right leg forward. Okay. So we've got left knee directly above left hip. We've got the right heel on the mat. We're drawing back into our right butt cheek. Okay. And we're just using the blocks as a balancing mechanism just to stabilize us. And then you're going to lift and actively float your right leg off. Press out the heel, draw the toes towards the nose. Deep breathing, so your core, everything's working to help support that leg lift. Round, and then we put the foot down to the floor, smooth the whole sole foot, and we'll bring our right knee forward. Bring the blocks forward if we need to. Just really open into your left hip flexor here, so it doesn't matter whether that knee is stabilized, we just want to bring it forward. Stretching out left hip flexor. Lovely. And then we're going to step right knee over the right ankle. Okay. And then curl the toes with the left foot. Bring that left foot back as much as we can without displacing the placement position of our right knee. So once we've got it back as far as we can, soften the toe on the mat. So this knee has to stay stable. Okay. You can use your block support. You're going to bend your left knee. Reach back with your left hand. Hug it into your bum. And then back with your right hand. So again, if you can release both hands, it doesn't matter. But you want to draw the heel in and lift up that head chest and bring it back towards that heel. Just breathe into that lovely quad. And then as we release it down, we're taking the left knee out wider, swinging the left foot behind the left knee, toes still curled under, slide your right foot back a little bit, press your right knee forward, left hip feels like you're drawing it to the front of your mat, lovely hip flexor, might not be lovely, it might feel quite tight in there, just breathe into it. So when we will think like our left hip's going forward, even though we've got an open knee hip position. Lovely, and then we'll release the hands down. We'll bring that knee back and blind curl, trying to lift the back knee, step that foot in pyramid pose. So just doing that little flow in between to take this pressure off my knees. Walk the blocks forward. And just place them there. And then we'll float it all the way up as if we're going to do triangle. Reverse, stretch left arm down, left leg. As we sweep it forward, left arm is coming to right little toes, side right arm sweeping back. Inhale, reach it up, bend right knee, stretch it up and over. As we inhale to come to center, extend it out, triangle pose. From triangle pose, bending right knee, turning eye gaze to left thumb. And then we'll spark it all the way down as we bring the hands either side of that front foot, roll onto the ball of your left foot. Slide right leg all the way up to the sky, three-legged dog. Bending right knee, pushing knee up to the sky, foot to left mat, roll onto left little toe side, modified side plank, find the float of the hips to the sky. So just think about placing the positioning now. Don't let your left leg slide away. So as you bring your right hand down, you're just rolling right over that foot, tapping your right knee in. Reaching up, grabbing your right foot with your left hand, stretching it away. And then we'll take it all the way back into our three-legged dog. And then we're going to step right foot to right little finger side. Square it off here. So we want to make sure that that leg is behind that left arm, knees drawn forward. And then we'll pop onto our knee. We'll take our blocks in between again. And just gently press that up. So we're going to come to rest our elbows on the blocks. Interlace the fingers. Squeeze the right thigh into the right shoulder. And just lift and float that left knee off the mat. So pressing back into that left heel. Drawing your right inside thigh onto your right shoulder. So then what's the core going on here as well as your hip mobility? You're really draw belly button to spine. As we release that left knee, remember it's behind our left elbow, we're going to come up. Keep our right knee in line with our right ankle. We need to work that left leg back a little bit, work it back a little bit. Left knee bends. You can keep a hold onto your box if you need to. Drawing that left heel in, reaching back. So now we've an open, wider stance between our two legs. Keep drawing that heel in. Lovely, and then as we release it down, we're just going to spill our right knee out wide. So roll out another little bit. And then we'll take the block diagonally across the mat, okay? Sweep our right leg over, side edge of our right thigh sits onto that block. Open hip position, okay? So make sure your right shin's parallel with the front of the mat. Square off your pelvis. Again, you can be resting up onto your hands, or you can rest onto your forearms, or you can fully stretch it away, whatever works for you. Just really sink the weight onto that block, into that hip. Just like release. Let go. And occasionally walk that back leg away.
Lovely.
So to come off this here, okay, you're just going to swing the bum round. Okay, so now we're going to bring our right heel in and our left. So our left heel in and our right leg across. So we've mirrored the legs now. So when you have this lovely, what we call accomplished sitting pose here, you've got no crossover of the legs at all. Draw the sit bones, really make sure the flesh of the sit bones is rested out. We can just take the block out in front of us. Again, resting onto our forearms. Okay. So as you come into the forward fold aspect of this, because the leg position is slightly different, it's not as easy to keep the butt cheeks grounded on the floor. So if you've got the arms out in front of you, you're creeping the way, you want to make sure your bum's still firmly on the floor. So that's why even just resting the forearms onto the block, be enough for you to be able to release into that right hip. Lovely. One last breath here. And then as we come back to our center point, okay, you're going to swing your right leg back, a little zigzag shape. Turn head, neck, chest, and just reach out to the front of your mat. And then we'll sweep the arms all the way back in from the back into our downward facing dog. And ripple forward into plank pose, exhaling in through your Chaturanga Dandasana, cobra or upward facing dog as you inhale. Exhaling into downward facing dog. Inhale, floating left leg up to the sky, stepping left foot to little finger side again, sliding right leg away. So finding that full length and extension here. Keep that right foot really stabilized. Bend your elbows as if you want to bring your forearms to the floor. So keep that left knee hopped into the left shoulder. So almost should be down the level with your left shoulder. Good. Then take your left arm behind your left leg. Right arm away to the right side of the mat. Square off your pelvis by always drawing your right hip forward to your right shoulder, left hip, left knee onto your left shoulder, and then just gently float the arms out into your airplane. Lift your chest all forward, press into the back of that left leg. And then we'll release the hands inside. We'll send it back into our plank pose. Exhaling the knees on or off the mat, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhaling into downward facing dog. Big breath out here. Then inhale, floating right leg up to the sky. Stepping right foot to right little toe side. Okay. So lengthen the left leg away. Square it off. Heart center's lifted, we've got suction of right knee to right shoulder. And then we're going to bend our forearms. So as soon as you bend your elbows and your forearms come to fall, your bum will pop up a little bit. That is fine. Hug in with your right knee. Press forward with your left hip. Sweep your right arm out behind your right leg, left arm out wide to the side of the mat. Suction everything into the middle of the mat and just gently float the arms. So feel like you're pulling your chest in forward. Lovely, and then we'll release the hands. We'll step our right leg all the way back. Exhale, knees on the mat. Chest will drop, legs and feet slide away. Relax the hands inside, or you just turn your head back to one side. So soften out the shoulders. Relax fully down to the mat. Lovely. So we're going to come back to center. Make sure, okay, that you really press the front thighs into the mat here. Okay. We're going to extend our right arm in front of us. Forehead rests on the mat. I'm going to bend our left knee. Keep the knee in line with the hip, reach back with our left hand, find our left ankle. And then we're going to come into half locus, half bow pose. So draw flexion into that foot. Already feel the front hips pressing into the mat. And then as we inhale, we're throwing up right arm, right leg, left thigh. Now push back with that left foot, press the belly button into the mat, and push and point into your right foot and leg. Brilliant. And gently releasing again. Sweep the arms around, just let your head fall to the other side, round over your shoulders. Soften the breath. And then we'll swap it around to the other side. So left arm's coming out in front of us. We're going to bend our right knee, place flexion into the foot, reach back with our right hand, find our right ankle. Forehead's just gently resting into the mat. So, we've got to press our front hip, flex the hips into the mat. And as we inhale, float up head, neck, chest. Push the right foot back. Float and push into your left side. A little bit more lift into the right thigh. A little bit more lift into the left leg, left arm. Try not to hold your breath. Lovely. And then we'll release it down. Release that leg. Bring the hands in underneath the shoulders and just very gently press up into your tabletop and back into your wide-kneed hair pose. Lovely. And then gently pressing up into the table. We'll just swing the legs through. Roll over our bums. Bring our bums into the middle of the mat. Gently lie down. And give yourself a wee moment here just to relax it out. Lovely. Put the 2 feet onto the floor. And gently swing the legs out to the right. Head, neck to the left. And then we can swing that left leg up and over a little bit. Maybe hook the side of the left ankle to the side of the right knee. Give yourself a little bit extra. And then we inhale into center, just soften around the other side. So straighten out the spine. Swing the knees off to the left, head to the right. And then we can take that right leg up and over. Just hook the side out on the side edge of the knee. Place the hand onto that thigh, gently turn to the right. Super, and then we'll bring all the way back to center, tuck the knees in one last time. And just pop the 2 feet onto the mat. So from here, smoothing the lower back onto the mat, sliding the legs and feet away, just really smooth out the glutes, butt cheeks into the mat, soften the side edges of the feet down into the mat, little toe side pulls out. And we'll just place our hands on our hips and on the tummy, or just out wide by our side. Close the eyes. Just settle into your breath. As you bring awareness into your body, how does it feel from the start of your class? Just allowing yourself to center your breath in any areas that need any extra attention. So maybe the back, the shoulders.
breathing steady and evenly, just letting go of all the work that you've done. Falling into the stillness around you, the peace, the quiet. Lovely. So from here, just gently walk in the feet in. Smooth the lower back into that, tuck the knees in, give yourself a super duper squeeze in. Gentle roll from side to side. And from here, we'll roll it up into our easy cross leg. Well done, everybody. Have a lovely day. Namaste.